This engine earns remarks for reliability. Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today with a video on the most common BMW M62 engine problems. The M62 is a 3.5 to 4.6 liter V8 that was produced from 1995 through 2005. It replaced the BMW M60 engine, which at the time had been BMW's first V8 engine in over 20 years. Now, when it comes to the M62 specifically, there is one notable thing to discuss, and that is the technical update that occurred in 1998. The most notable part of that technical update that is also applicable to this video was the introduction of the single VANOS system for the intake camshaft. That updated engine is often referred to as the M62TU. There were a couple other small updates with that technical update and M62TU. However, really just wanted to point out the introduction of VANOS, since that directly applies to reliability and common problems of the BMW M62. With that said, let's go ahead and dive straight in and discuss some of the most common issues with the BMW M62. Number one on the list, we have timing chain guide failure. The BMW M62 does indeed use a metal timing chain, and due to that, the timing chain guides are actually made from plastic or a plastic-like material. And naturally, over time, any plastics or plastic-like materials are prone to degradation and natural wear and tear. So this tends to be a common issue and failure point, specifically in the ballpark of about 100,000 to 200,000 miles. So not something that's going to be an issue or a concern super early on. However, with the age of the M62 nowadays, if this hasn't been done, it's certainly something to knock out as soon as possible. And even if this repair was already addressed, it may be time to do it for a second time, especially if the timing chain guides were replaced, let's say at 100,000 miles. Ultimately, timing chain guide failure often isn't a huge concern. However, one potential complication and one reason this is a good thing to address as preventative maintenance is because the M62 is an interference engine, and that actually means that there is some overlap in the area that the pistons and valves travel. And ultimately, that means if the timing chain guides fail and allow the timing chain to jump enough, that could actually throw off engine timing significantly enough to allow the pistons and valves to collide with each other. And that can lead to a host of expensive, very serious issues. So this could be something that wipes out the entire engine potentially. Again, this is very unlikely to happen, but it is an important thing to point out as a reason that this is good preventative maintenance. If you're addressing this preventatively, somewhere around that 120,000 to 150,000 mile ballpark is a good time to go ahead and address this. Moving on to another common problem, we have VANOS failure. So VANOS is simply BMW's terminology for variable valve timing. And again, this technology was added in the form of single VANOS in 1998 for the M62TU variant. Now, a few common failure points with the VANOS system on the M62 include the VANOS seals, VANOS solenoids, as well as the actual adjuster unit itself. When you run into issues with any of the VANOS system, it's a good idea to do a complete refresh, not only on the VANOS system, but also a number of other parts that will be accessible during that repair job. A few things to be on the lookout for there include additional items like the valve cover gaskets, the upper timing cover gaskets, the VANOS solenoid gaskets themselves, cam seal rings, etc. All great gaskets and inexpensive parts to replace while you're in there doing any kind of VANOS work. And again, a lot of the times a full refresh on that VANOS system is also a great idea. Potentially one thing to skip over is the adjuster unit itself, since that can be fairly expensive. But again, if you're looking to own the M62 for the longer term and are looking to knock things out, replacing all of that preventatively can help make the M62 much more reliable, not just for the short term, but for the much longer term. Moving on to our third and final common M62 engine problem. Lumping a few things together, we have issues with the cooling system. Here, I'm not really talking about just one or two cooling system components. It's mostly the entire cooling system that can be problematic, especially with enough mileage and enough age on the cooling system. As these cooling systems hit that 10 plus year old mark, a lot of different failures are all fair game and become somewhat common issues. That includes things things like the radiator, the coolant expansion tank, water pump, thermostat, coolant hoses, etc. So if you're in the market for an M62, if you find one that's had some of this cooling system work done in the recent past, then that's a great benefit. Otherwise, if none of this has been addressed in a long time, it's a good idea to go ahead and plan for that and budget for potentially doing a pretty full cooling system refresh. Not all of this has to be done preventatively by any means. However, updating and refreshing that cooling system can be a great way to ensure the M62 remains reliable and doesn't potentially leave you stranded with an overheating engine. So again, none of the cooling system issues individually are really incredibly common problems, and not everything is going to fail, and certainly not fail at the same time. Anything with the cooling system is fair game after about 8 to 10 years or 80 to 100,000 plus miles. And the more you address with the cooling system, the better off you'll likely be in the longer term. Now, tying this all together and looking at overall BMW M62 reliability, this engine earns average remarks for reliability. The earlier M62 variants that didn't receive the technical update tend to be a little bit more reliable. They're also very simplistic engines that are easy to work on, so that's a big upside to the earlier engines that did not receive the technical update, and most importantly, the single VANOS system on the intake cam. So looking at those technically updated engines from 1998 onwards, the VANOS does add another major failure point and adds a lot more complexity to the engine that can make it a little bit harder to work on and overall make the engine a little more complex and expensive to own and maintain. So just something to consider if you're in the market for an M62. There are benefits to each engine. The technical update with the VANOS does offer better power and a better overall power band. However, it does add some complexity. And that's even true when it comes to aftermarket mods. And so just something to consider there. Again, if you're in the market for one, whether or not you pick up an M62 or the M62 TU, there isn't really a right or wrong answer. However, again, the original M62 without the VANOS can be a little bit more reliable and just a more simplistic engine to own and maintain. Now, all of that said, both variants can both be reliable engines even to this very day. However, they're old engines and they are going to require a little extra TLC. Things like the VANOS system, cooling system, and timing chain are all important things to address and additionally knock out any other maintenance you can while you're in those areas. If you do that and just stay on top of any repairs and potential issues, these can be very reliable engines despite the fact that the M62 is now 20 to 30 years old. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.